Hello, friends! Happy New Year! Happy 2022! I haven't posted since last year, but I also didn't really post any holiday content last year or do anything revolving around the holidays. So, figured we would start this video off with a little bit of a life chat, or life update rather. I did a little bit of posting on Instagram stories, so if you follow me on there, which you should, you would have already heard some of this. But to cut to the chase, that looks awful. It is what it is. I got COVID for Christmas, so that was fun. I got my positive PCR test on Christmas morning, and so plans kind of changed a little bit, but not too much. We just had to move our flights home and ended up coming home on New Year's Eve versus Boxing Day. So I ended up spending a lot more time at home with my family. All of them are good and okay, barely had any symptoms. I'm still a bit in recovery mode. I still have like this 5 day or 6 day now headache, and it's been really fun. I'm still a bit congested and the fatigue. I'm really tired like all the time. So this is the first time I'm picking up the camera this year, and I want to get back into vlogging, but I'm gonna take it slow because as soon as like 4 o'clock hits, I get super tired. Yesterday I had a nap and it's been a lot. But I haven't put on makeup in what feels like 2 weeks, and one of my goals this year, or resolutions if you will, is to actually get ready for the day. I mean, it's 1 p.m., a little later start than I wanted to, but we're doing it. So yeah, I had COVID over Christmas. My symptoms were really not that bad, and like I said, I'm on the mend, I'm doing well, and yeah, I hope you guys all had a good holiday break as well and took some time off social media or just took some time off work, because I feel like this year especially we all needed it, and I feel like I've seen a lot of people online taking a break, which is really nice and refreshing, and it makes it okay for you to do. I just got done with therapy. We did an online session this time because my therapist has COVID, and I hope she recovers soon. But yeah, we did our session online, which was kind of nice. I didn't really want to have to drive downtown today, so it kind of just like saved me a bit of time, and I'm in a good mindset to go into the rest of today, which is kind of nice. I'm loving my makeup. Even though I haven't really been wearing a ton of it, I've been playing around with some new things, which if you guys want me to do like an updated makeup routine, I can definitely do that. But Nude Stix actually sent me some products, which I was so excited. I hadn't had any PR sent from Nude Stix before, and their tinted cover foundation and their cream concealer have been amazing. I love them. They're like medium coverage, but they're so hydrating, and they work really well on the skin, and they sent me like my exact shade, Nude 2.5, and yeah, I've really been enjoying those. So if you want to see like a full proper makeup routine for the new year, then let me know, but I've been loving those. I feel like my brain is really struggling with like doing my makeup and also talking to you guys, so I'm gonna do my makeup and then I will talk to you. All right, makeup is done. I probably won't do my hair just because it looks decent enough. I put on lashes because I just wanted to feel something. These are the Ardell Wispies. I don't know, I'm so out of practice with putting on lashes that I need to get back into the habit of doing them just so I don't lose the skill. And also because I'm using new lash glue and I feel like it's not as good as my old stuff, but I need to get used to it. Anyway, did lashes, did the rest of my makeup. I barely did any eyeshadow just because I knew these would be, they're very large, but it feels good.
Yes?
I know. We're vlogging. It's crazy. As for my lip combo, I got these two items in my stocking. I have this lip liner, but I lost it, and so I was able to get another one. This is the Oak lip pencil from MAC. I love it. It's so nice, and hopefully I find the other one that I lost, because I'd like to have two, so I can have one here and one in my purse. And then I also got this Merit Taupe Tinted Lip Oil. I had the Au Naturel one, which is obviously a little bit more warm tone, but this one is a little bit more cooler brown, and so that's what I have on my lips today. And I haven't really had a chance to properly wear it, and I really like it. And it's a good combo with the Oak, so that's what I have on my lips. I didn't set my makeup, so I shall do that.
What do you have to say?
Hmm? Hello. Okay. At the top of the new year, I always feel like I want to upgrade a couple pieces of furniture, and I saw this chair at HomeSense and I got a gift card for Christmas, so I ended up buying it. I was actually going to buy a new like lounge chair,
So I'm still on the hunt for that because our cats have destroyed the one in our living room. But this chair at HomeSense was so cute. They had other ones with like a Sherpa cushion and it really just wasn't the vibe. So I saw this one and I was like, absolutely. I originally had a black chair in here, but that went out into the living room for Cody's desk chair because this, the chair I had previously is like wider and I always sit cross-legged, which probably isn't good for my knees, but I need a chair that I can sit cross-legged on and I can do that with this one. And it's so cute and the black trim matches like all of my frames and the mirror in this room and everything. So I kind of wanted to keep that going. Also too, the cane is just one of my favorite things ever and I feel like it's so cool with the black, and also it kind of matches like the little wicker I have here and the bins I have over here. Nothing's really organized, but at least it kind of all matches the vibe. I'm also the kind of person that until I know absolutely for sure that I love this chair, I'm not taking the price tag off, but I'm pretty sure I'm keeping it because I've sat in it for a couple days now and it's pretty comfy. And yeah, it's definitely a good comfy chair. This part is super thick, so it feels very like soft underneath me if I'm gonna be sitting for a long time. So, bought that at HomeSense, thought I'd share. So this is the chair that I want to replace. If you guys have any recommendations of like pretty reasonable chairs, because if you can see here, it's like completely falling apart and like there's staples showing, and I've actually like walked across this and it's tore holes in my leggings, which obviously I don't appreciate. So we need to get a new chair and I don't really know where to shop for one. I don't wanna spend too much money just in case they do destroy another one. But this is like becoming a hazard at this point. So yeah, looking for accent chair recommendations.
So as I mentioned, our plans got kind of changed around over the holiday break. And so we actually came home on New Year's Eve. And let me tell you, when I got home, all I wanted to do was clean up. And I had been waiting to get home. Even though I was sick, I was waiting to get home to clean because I was like, I knew the state that we had left our apartment in because I just didn't have any motivation throughout December to do literally anything. So I just could not wait to get home and to clean. And so we came home and New Year's Eve, we didn't put away the decorations that night because Cody was like, let's chill. We're not going out, so let's chill. So the next morning we got up and we put away all of the decorations, took down the tree, put everything back, and I feel so much better. And like I've vacuumed and I've steam mopped the floors because of all the snow. We've had a lot of snow here, which is unusual, but the floors were really dirty. And then I like deep cleaned my bathroom, which it feels so nice. And I'm trying to like keep the counters clean and I'm just like inspired to like keep my space a little bit tidier than it has been in the past just because it makes me feel so much better. And there are some other like furniture upgrades I want to do, but as you guys probably know, most furniture places are like really backstocked or like don't have things because of the supply chain issues. So yeah, I'm kind of waiting. There's a thing I want from IKEA, but who knows if that'll actually come to fruition. I just kind of want to tidy things up and mature things in our apartment and also just like declutter things that we don't touch. And I know that I have to do that for my studio room again, which I do like this time every year. I always go through my makeup, I go through my skincare, hair care, and I usually film that. So let me know if you guys are interested in those types of videos again, just because I feel like they're pretty redundant at this point, but you let me know. I just know that I need to properly declutter and that's like a huge goal because I would love this year to not have to do this 4 times a year and spend so much time or like spend weeks of my time organizing stuff and just like live in a nice clean space. So I don't know. These are all hopes, dreams, and wishes, but we'll see if we can actually do that.
For my afternoon coffee, I've been enjoying putting a little splash of chai just for some flavor, and then I'm gonna top it off with the Silk half and half.
Well, my afternoon evening headache is setting in a little bit early because it's only almost 2 o'clock now and I feel like it's coming on. So hopefully this caffeine helps. I have tried so many things to get rid of this headache and it's lasted. Like I think I'm on day 6. I've done peppermint halo, Advil, Tylenol, smoking. Like I've tried literally everything and it still keeps coming back every single day. So that's been super fun. So I kind of try and do something different every single day, but yeah, man, this thing is hard to kick. Hopefully this caffeine helps, but I also wanted to sit down and share with you guys some product empties. I feel like I've accumulated too many to do like an IGTV or just share on socials and stuff. So I want to sit down and do an empties little segment of this vlog. As you guys can see, I have quite a large bin full of empty products here, so I'm excited to talk to you about them and then get rid of them. First empty is something I actually just replaced, so I already had a backup from the Sephora sale. This is the Color Wow Dream Coat Supernatural Spray. If you're looking to get the best hair of your life in 2022, highly recommend this. It lasts so long and it helps speed up blow dry time, and it's just such an amazing product. I spray it on my hair every single time after I get out of the shower if I'm gonna blow dry it. It says you don't have to do that, and you can do every third shampoo, and it requires blow drying to activate, so you have to use this when you're gonna blow dry. But I use it every single time and I love it, and it's really great, and like I said, it lasts a long time. You can get it at Sephora, and then also my hair salon sells it. So I also have a little mini version that I travel with, so can't live without it. This is a huge face wash that I finally used up. This is a Bioderma CBM Purifying Cleansing Foaming Gel. Such a great acne wash. I really like it. It's kind of like a mild acne wash. It's not as strong as like a Benzogel, but it's a really good, just like keep your acne at bay. And I really liked having this, and it's very large, so definitely recommend that. I think I've probably used up a couple of these, but this is the deodorant that I like. It's the Dove Advanced Care. Don't really care what scent. I like the spray deodorant though, because it's really nice and you can share it when you're like at dance and stuff, because it's just a spray. Super easy. I have used up 2 of the Belief Aqua Balm moisturizers and 1 of the Belief Aqua Balm Brightening Vitamin C creams. I actually pulled out a different moisturizer to try. Shocking, I know. I do already have 2 backups of these. 3 backups? I have backups of these, obviously, but I wanted to try out a new moisturizer, so I'm trying out the Kylie Skin one. I've been using it for a couple days, and I actually really like it, and it's not too thick and not too, like, gel-like. It's just, like, a nice in-between. So far, so good. Not gonna say anything more about it, but, yeah, if you're looking for a good gel moisturizer, you guys know. Those are my favorite. Another great product from Bioderma, and especially good in the winter, is their Hydra BO Serum. It's just a, like, super moisturizing hydrating concentrate. It's also really great for travel because it's so light. So I have an empty of that. Very good. I used up a dry shampoo. This is the Kérastase Refreshing Dry Shampoo. This is like a bougie shampoo, and I'm so happy that I have a backup. They actually sent me a new one, and then I also purchased one. So that's how you know. It smells like perfume. It smells so good, and it's a pretty good dry shampoo. It's probably not worth the $50 if you have another good drugstore dry shampoo, but if you're looking to treat yourself, I do really like this. But I don't know if it's worth $50. Because, like, it's a lot for a dry shampoo, you know? I don't know if I've ever talked to you guys on here about my CBD addiction. It's not really an addiction, but I love CBD. And this was my first introduction to CBD from Calyx. It's a Canadian brand, I believe. And this is their Calm Spray. It's a, like, CBD oil spray. And this one was in peppermint or something. Spearmint? I'm not sure. I switch back between the two, but this is a really, really great product. Whenever I'm feeling anxious, this is the first thing I grab, and it's a spray, so it goes under your tongue, you let it sit for 30 seconds, and then you can swallow it, and it just tastes like mint. It doesn't have much taste to it at all, and I don't know if it's a placebo. I don't think it is, because it does really, really work, and I've had friends try it and really like it too, and it just, like, it really helps me, like, calm down, especially when I'm, like, really getting, like, high anxiety, when I'm just kind of, like, really up in my head. And I don't know, it's really hard to explain, but I really, really like this, and I'm kind of playing around with other things. They sent me a PR package for the holidays, which was really sweet, and it included another tincture, so I've been kind of trying between this and that. And I cannot recommend this enough. If you want to try something that has CBD in it, it doesn't get you high, it just kind of calms everything. And I love using it before I go on stage, because I get really, really jittery and, like, just really shaky and, like, really nervous, and this helps so, so much, especially, like, yeah, before I go on stage, before I go to bed. Like, there's just so many instances where I pull this out, and I like to have it, like, in my purse and everything. So highly recommend. I'll stop talking about it. It's so good. I went through Bondi Boost. So I have the shampoo, conditioner, hair mask, and also their intensive spray. This is how my hair grew in 2021. If you're looking to grow your hair thicker and longer, especially thicker, my hair has gotten so thick. Like, I need to go get my hair thinned out because it's so thick now. Highly recommend this. You can get it at Sephora. I will link it down below. I love every product, and I've repurchased all of it with my own money. I did work with them last year, but these I repurchased with my own money. I used up a Bioderma, which is my favorite way to remove my makeup. I finally used up the Laura Mercier powder. I mean, there's, like, a little bit left, but I've already opened a new one. Let me know your guys' favorite powder. I'm actually kind of curious about that because I've heard some mixed things about that, but I still really like it and it works well for my skin. But if you have a favorite powder, loose or pressed, let me know what it is. I used up a Balm Dia Bright cream. I did really like this and it smells really good. But the price you pay for such a small amount of lotion, I just don't know if I would do it again. This is definitely a sweeter scent. The other one, the original, is a little bit more musky. This one's like berries and stuff, but it did have retinol in it, or vitamin C, which was kind of nice. But yeah, such a small amount of lotion. But I do like that the scent lingered on your body. I quite enjoyed that. A body wash I used up was the Olay Cleansing and Nourishing Hyaluronic Acid Body Wash. It was pretty good. I actually was sent a lavender one from the same line, so that's what I'm currently using at the moment. This was another body wash I used up. This is the Caudalie Soleil de... I'm not gonna be able to pronounce it. It's a shower gel and it smells like sunscreen. It was what I used in the summer. It was really, really nice and I really like the scent of it. Again, a bougie little shower gel. You guys know I love Hum Nutrition and there is so much gross stuff on all of the products in here. I don't know what leaked, but I need to get rid of these things. Anyway, used up quite a few of the Skin and Skin Squad Pre and Probiotic. This is a game changer for clearing skin along with a couple of the other supplements I take, but I do have a subscription to Hum and I really like their stuff. So I have backups of these already and I do truly feel like they helped clear up my skin, and like my skin's not perfect by any means, but I definitely think it helped quite a bit. I used up a 2-Hour Express from Loving Tan, favorite tanner. I love the 2-Hour Express, I love the regular, I love the dark, I love the ultra dark. Hands down, like, my favorite self-tanner because it just lasts the longest on me. Although I have been really enjoying my Isle of Paradise, like, airbrush spray air. What's that called? Spray tan kit. I have really been enjoying that. I used up a Clarins Relax Bath and Shower Concentrate with essential oils. This was really nice. It lasted a really long time and I used it as a bubble bath and it worked really well and it smelled really nice. So I quite enjoyed that. I used up a Matrix Miracle Extender Dry Shampoo. Another great dry shampoo. I believe this one's a little bit more affordable than the Kerastase one. Used up another Dove deodorant. You guys saw this one on my Instagram. This is the JS Health Hair and Energy Capsule Supplements. And this is what kickstarted my like hair growth journey that I've been kind of been on for the past year or so. This is what kind of inspired it, because this kickstarted the hair growth, and so then I just continued it on with the other products. A skincare product I used up was the 15% Vitamin C and Clean Caffeine Energy Serum, and other than Belief moisturizers, I so rarely use up skincare products, so this is like props to me. And it was really fantastic. It is a bit pricey. I recommend it to you guys during the Sephora sale just because it is quite pricey, but it works so well. It helps to brighten dark spots and it's a serum, so it's really nice and hydrating to put on in the morning. That's when you want to put on your vitamin C. And I thoroughly enjoyed everything about this product. It's such a good product from Youth of the People. I'm a big fan of a lot of their products and they kindly sent me a replacement, which is so nice. So I am going to be using that again once I finish the current vitamin C I'm using, because I'm really trying hard to not open things and use things until the current one is done. I'm really bad at it and I really want to get better, but yes, that product is fantastic. And then a couple other things. I used up a 24-hour brow setter. I used up this Herbivore Bakuch oil. It was nice. Great little sample size. It was good. I don't think I'm gonna be buying the full size, but I did like it. And then this is probably what's making a mess. This is from Cake. It's their Cakewalk Minty Buttered Oil Intensely Conditioning Totally to Die For Rich and Reviving Foot Pretty Cream. What a name. It's a foot cream. As a dancer, I feel like my feet are always needing help. And applying a cooling foot cream is just like so nice, especially putting on fuzzy socks after and then tucking yourself into bed. There's nothing like it. This is a great one and I believe you can find it at the drugstore. But yeah, I don't know if I've ever recommended a foot cream, but if you're looking for one, this one was good. That is everything I used up in the past probably 6 months or so. That's crazy. There's a lot of products here. But I'm very excited to have shown you guys and now I can toss all the bottles. This is actually really nice and encouraging to see all of these products because it encourages me and inspires me to continue to use up products and actually use them to the end, which is great. If you guys had a favorite product last year, skincare, hair care, beauty, whatever it is, makeup item, please let me know what it was in the comments down below. I used to do like yearly favorites videos really long time ago back in the day, and I've been thinking about doing like a current favorites if you guys are interested in that. But yeah, let me know your product, top product from last year, because I'm very curious.
Cody's home. He brought me lunch. It's 3 o'clock now.
I got the Santa Fe chicken salad.
Yes, noodle. And it looks really good. So I'm gonna eat that.
Hello and good morning. It's Thursday. It's almost noon. And Cody and I are heading to Lougheed Laser because I have a laser hair removal appointment. And it snowed so much last night. I had a couple friends over and they stayed pretty late and we got to go walk out in the snow and it's so pretty, but it has caused a mess on the roads because Vancouver is just simply not used to this much snow. It's pretty crazy. I will show you guys after. And yeah, so I stayed up pretty late, feeling a little tired. Love the snow because it's very bright. It's a lot better in my personal opinion, although people do not know how to drive in it here. It's a lot brighter and happier than rain, so I'm kind of enjoying it. Makes for pretty pictures. You just have to give yourself a lot of extra time to get to where you're going, and Lougheed is not close to our home, so we had to plan for this. So hopefully we make it there in one piece. Later, but we're home from running all of our errands today. We kind of just ended up getting a lot of things done that we didn't really plan on it. Like, we got a last minute doctor's appointment for Cody, and then we had to like get a pee sample for Noodle and take that to the vet, and like just a bunch of like really annoying tasks. And obviously with all the snow it was just like a little bit slower. So it's 5 p.m. now, we're home. I'm going to now do some laundry. I want to wash these new sheets I bought. I was looking specifically for flannel sheets, which obviously you can really only find this time of year because it's winter. They are so soft. Do yourself a favor if you're a cold sleeper. Definitely recommend getting flannel sheets. They're so, so cozy. They did actually have some of these UGG ones at HomeSense, but they only had white and they only had king size at like 3 locations I went to. So we ended up going to Bed Bath & Beyond and they had them there as well, which is really exciting. We decided on this like really nice like nude plaid color. They had a couple other colors, but this one seemed to fit the vibe of our bed the best. So I'm gonna pull all of this stuff out and wash it. I also just got a package in from Amazon that's like a new duvet insert because I want to fluff up our bed and make it even more cozy because it's what I desire. And I wanna have 2 inserts in our duvet. And I think that's really gonna like puff it up and thicken it. And I cannot wait. I feel like I just want it to look like cloud-like and just like a little bit more puffy. So I have to wash the sheets and then we can do that. I'm also getting my post-COVID nightly headache, so I'm gonna do some research and just like look into that a little bit. It's really starting to get frustrating. I think this is like day 7 and I am prone to headaches, so like it's not new to me, but having one that lasts and is like routine showing up every single night is not fun. So I'm gonna peppermint halo my temples and do some laundry. And then this is the duvet insert that I got from Amazon. I'll link it down below if it's good. I'm gonna obviously open it up. Hopefully it puffs up a little bit. I believe it was only like $40. I really did not want to spend a lot of money because our actual duvet insert that we have right now, I think I spent about like $100 on it originally. So I wasn't about to spend like another $100 on another duvet insert, but I feel like this one is gonna be a good like addition. When I open it here. Oh yeah, for sure. Look at that expansion. It's really soft too. It's pretty thin. It's not like super, super thick and puffy. It's obviously just like cotton. I think this will be a good addition to the current one we already have.
Okay, I have the new sheets on the bed and they are so soft, like so much softer than my other sheets even. And I'm just so excited to sleep in this tonight. And I switched out the pillows. So I have like our regular pillows are the white pillowcases. Then we have the plaid and then we have this cream one, and those are from H&M Home. We also only usually use the fitted sheets. So I have the flat sheet just kind of tucked away that I'll put in our linen stuff because we just never use a second sheet. But yeah, so cozy, just waiting for the duvet cover to dry and then I will make the rest of the bed. We have a pretty healthy dinner tonight. Cody made some boneless chicken thighs and we did that on a spring salad with some cucumber, red pepper, and avocado, which I got this new device for Christmas. It is so cool for like cubing avocado, makes it really easy. And then we just had some leftover roasted potatoes. So that's gonna be our dinner. And I'm actually really looking forward to this because I have blood work in the morning and so I have to stop eating at like 10. And I think this is going to do a good job of filling me up for the night.
Dinner was so, what are you doing? He's changing the lights because he put these like, I showed these on Instagram, these like strip lights. I don't know if you guys can see that. On the back of the wall or back of the TV, and then whatever's playing, it'll like see the colors. I'm not explaining this very well. And it'll change the color according to what's on the TV and we're watching Pen 15. What I was gonna say was dinner was really good and our duvet cover is freshly clean and warm, and so we're gonna see if this works, putting two duvet inserts into the cover, and I'm going to put it on a time lapse, but if you guys are interested to see how we do our like duvet roll technique, I have a reel and a TikTok on both of my pages if you wanna like learn a new hack for doing your duvet cover. It's really, really easy, but not so sure how it's gonna go with two. Bitch. No, our bed looks different. We're not reusing old footage. Yeah. What does it matter? We're standing here, we're gonna do it. What's it to you? The camera's there.
I'm wearing.
It's stupid to do with a cat on the bed. Is this inside out? Right? Max, the heater's on, you're gonna catch it on fire.
No.
Yeah.
You say, I'm here when I want to.
Help me? Either of you?
What do you need help with?
Can you hide? I love you, but get out.
Not the tag at the bottom of the tongue.
Yeah, the bottom. Shower, do like a nightly body shower, and I was gonna wash my hair, but I don't think I'm going to, just because I might do a workout tomorrow and I just don't really feel like doing that whole process tonight. So I decided instead I would use a couple products in my hair overnight. So I use the Bondi Boost Intensive Spray, and then I'm trying to use up other random hair products. This one is from Kerastase, and this is the Nutritive 8-Hour Magic Night Serum. So I just applied a generous amount of this on the ends and it smells so good. In the morning, if your hair was like styled, it'd be totally fine. Again, you can wash it, it doesn't really matter. It like dries down, it doesn't leave it like soaking wet, if that makes sense. Same with the intensive spray, but yeah, put those in my hair. Gonna do a brush through, put it up in a bun, and then hop in the shower.